Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Keith, and welcome to my review of the film The First Purge. This is one of those films that I was eagerly anticipating, and it has finally arrived. Now, if you're not familiar with the Purge series, this is a film that basically takes place in the not-too-distant future. Every year, during a 12-hour period of time, all crime, including murder, is illegal. Now, the first Purge movie saw Ethan Hawke star as a father and security expert, and him and his well-off family were bunkered in their house trying to survive a home invasion. The second Purge took us on the streets as we saw a group of people who came together through circumstance trying to survive this devastating night. The third film had more of a political feel to it, as we had a senator who was trying to running for president, trying to get rid of the Purge, while the new founding fathers were trying to stop her. So now, of course, it only made sense in the fourth installment we wanted to go all the way back to how it started, and that brings us to the prequel film, The First Purge. Now, in this film, we don't necessarily call it the Purge as much, it's more so the experiment. The new founding fathers have taken office because they're an alternative to the Democrats and the Republicans, and they want to help balance things out. And the way they want to do that is to give people an opportunity to purge and to murder. So Marissa Tomei plays the scientist who's behind the whole rationale behind this, and she is basically in cahoots with the new founding fathers as they sit back from their command center and watch everything unfold. Now, the thing is that it's not unfolding at the pace that they want it to, so they decide they need to take matters into their own hands. The Purge is becoming more of a political movie, as we saw in the last film, Election Year. And this film is no different. There are so many things in this movie that mirror what's happening in society, whether it be channeling the Charleston murders or basically looking at race relations in the States. It wasn't lost on me that you had in this film a white president who didn't really seem to care very much about the inner city. Now, in this film, it's also interesting because when you take a look back at the other Purge movies, everybody's fair game in terms of who's getting killed. Whereas in this film, it just seemed to be mainly, let's go out and kill people of color, mainly black people. There are a lot of images in this film that not only seem to resemble what's going on in America right now, but also images that were at times very strong and very powerful. So to the filmmakers, job well done. My challenge with this film was the fact that when I think of prequel movies and great prequel movies that we've seen recently, one that comes to mind is Rogue One. I think Rogue One basically set the bar in terms of what a prequel should look like. The challenge with this film is that, without giving too much away, I didn't feel that there was enough of a tie-in between this film and the other movies in the series. This film also left me with a lot of unanswered questions. I will say, from a character development standpoint, one thing that makes this film different than the other Purge movies is there are a lot of different characters in this film that we have an opportunity of getting to know. There were definitely some jump scares in this film as well, and I thought those were done pretty effectively. But there are some themes in this film and some character types in this film that we've seen in other Purge movies. So it was a decent prequel. I just feel that it could have been a lot stronger. I definitely think people who've seen the other Purge movies should go and check this out, and I think for the most part you'll enjoy it. It is very strongly political, but those are the times that we live in. Does it come across as preachy? Not so much. It just makes you come across thinking to yourself, if the Purge happens, you really have to like look for cover or look for somebody to have your back. I think the Childish Gambino song, This Is America, would have been the perfect song to be playing in the post-credits of this film, because there were aspects of this movie that just felt like an extended version of that polarizing video. It's an entertaining movie. I give it a C+. I didn't like it, again, as much as I like the other Purge films, but again, if you've seen the others, you definitely want to check this out. I'm interested to see where the series goes from here, if there is another Purge movie, but again, it's always very interesting when you look at whether it's a movie like The Purge or a show like The Walking Dead, when there's no sort of law and order, chaos usually ensues. Decent film, but there are better in this series. If you get a chance to see The First Purge, I'd love to know what you think. CFL_fan on Twitter, facebook.com/WittyWhittier and WittyWhittier.com. Thank you so much for checking this out. My name is Keith, and I'll see you at the movies.